The top three ladies have something extra to prove tonight to erase past disappointments. The once invincible Michelle Kwan has continued to win, but has struggled in doing so. Have her studies away from the ice distracted the 19-year-old from winning her third world title? The reigning world champion Maria Butyrskaya is also battling an inconsistent streak. This isn't the first time the veteran has struggled on the ice, but a win this week would silence her critics once again. The favorite may be Irina Slutskaya, who continues her amazing comeback. She missed last year's world championships and nearly quit skating. She's dominated this season, though, and only one prize eludes her, the world gold. At 14 years of age, Sarah Hughes has nothing to fear. Her athleticism is combined with a grace beyond her years. The combination puts Hughes in contention for her first world medal. The ladies are next. Back inside the Palais des Expositions here in Nice, France, the 2000 World Figure Skating Championships continue now. The ladies on the ice warming up for their short program. Hi again, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. It has already been a wild week here in Nice at the World Championships, and you can't come to expect the unexpected. And maybe that will hold true here in the ladies' event. When you look at the field, unlike most years, there is really not a clear-cut favorite, a chalk horse who you can say everyone else is gunning at. Welcome in right now, Mr. Dick Button. And talking about the field, you've got two world champions. In fact, the world champs from the past 2 years, Dick, Maria Butyrskaya and Michelle Kwan. I'm not sure they're the favorites here.
Well, you know, over the past half a century, and that's a long time, I've played almost every role that skating has to offer, except one. I have never, ever, ever, and thank heavens for that, been a judge. Why? Because they have the toughest job of all. Now, in this competition, those two world champions, Michelle Kwan and Maria Butyrskaya, both have had some pretty bad moments so far this year. So how do you judge them? This short program calls for 8 elements. All the top skaters do much the same difficulty. If they all skate well, the judges then have to make a decision based on artistry. And that is subjective, and therefore it is difficult. So I suspect some secretly hope for mistakes to be made so their job will be a little easier. Don't expect either Kwan or Butyrskaya to oblige them. They haven't survived in this jungle this long without learning a thing or two about how to compete.
Somehow they do know how to bring it together when everything is on the line. We welcome in right now Peggy Fleming. Glad to have you with us, Peggy. You look at the field with the two champions that Dick just talked about. I think most people, though, talking about another Russian champion right now, and that's Irina Slutskaya.
Well, that's right, Terry. Irina Slutskaya is the only skater to have beaten both Michelle Kwan and Maria Butyrskaya this season, and she's emerging as the favorite here in Nice. She wasn't even on the Russian world team last year, and she has completely reinvented herself this year. Irina has always been a technical typhoon, but another skater is creating a technical storm for Michelle, too. She's the youngest skater here, and at 14, Michelle's teammate Sarah Hughes is beginning to push everyone technically as well as artistically. She comes from a family of 6 children, so she's already familiar with how to navigate in a crowd. And this world championship may be the turning point for Sarah Hughes.
And a family of 6 very competitive athletes as well. Well, here's how the scoring breaks down for the ladies. There's already been a qualifying round worth 20%, the short program worth 30%, and the free skate worth 50%. As always, 8 required elements here in the short, 2 minutes and 40 seconds in length, and the jump combination, always a key. We get underway with the homegirl, the French national champion, Vanessa Guzmaroli. The 97 world bronze medalist.
And just to put her in perspective, she's also a snowboarder, a skier, plays golf, and is the French national water skiing champion in the under 21 category. And that athleticism hopefully will add up right here in this combination. First, triple Lutz. A very nice and a double toe.
Good stretch on that spiral. Very different position with her arms behind her back.
Mm-hmm.
almost a majestic quality. Nothing frivolous about her stroking or performing or moving over the ice. Look at this. Triple flip. Beautifully done.
She had planned on doing a triple toe, but she has been battling an injury on her left ankle all season.
Well, a triple flip is far more difficult than a triple toe.
That'll probably help her in the long run in this short program.
Spin combination.
Mentioned this week that she watched the French team, Abby Bolin, Bernadese in Paris in their short program and got so nervous just listening to the crowd, realizing that she didn't want to let them down here. She had to find a quiet place and get away from everything.
She's skating very powerfully, very strongly, good speed, steady jumps.
This performance had a lot of confidence. Very different from the qualifying event that she did. She had a lot of trouble. But at the European Championship, she had the skate of a lifetime.
You know, this is pretty good, I've got to tell you.
Yes.
One of the better performances that I've ever seen her give.
She was only in seventh place in her qualifying group. There are two qualifying groups that split up the ladies' field. So when you work that out, basically she was tied for 14th coming into this short program. Yeah, there's a reason for that smile. Vanessa Guzmaroli.
I think this short program will redeem her for sure. And this was the solo jump she chose to do in this short program, the triple flip. There she is tapping in for her takeoff. Very nice and solid, straight in the air. Very strong, very confident.
Well, you mentioned the ankle injury, Peggy. She also switched coaches in November. There's Stanislav Leonovich along with her. First set for required elements, 5.2 to 5.6.
Well, that was a very strong and, you know, very controlled performance. There was nothing jazzy or awkward or out of line.
And the presentation marks now 5.4 up to 5.7. Those even better. Vanessa Guzmaroli from France. When we come back, Victoria Volchkova, the 17-year-old from Russia, takes the ice right after this here at the World Championships.
Victoria Volchkova.
Victoria Volchkova, the 17-year-old originally from St. Petersburg, who now lives in Moscow, representing Russia, recently won the bronze medal for the second straight year at the European Championships.
And she has the rhythm and the speed and technique on her jumps. Watch the height and spring she gets on these jumps, and she's opening the program with the triple lutz, double toe.
Wonderful spring, even though it was only a double. Look at the height that she gets.
She's a real natural jumper.
It's very unusual that somebody as tall as she is can jump like that.
She's 5'5", but she looks even taller than that. Fourth in her qualifying group coming into the short program.
See how she tackles this triple flip. Very, very easy and smooth. If you noticed, she went into it from a straight edge, not a curved edge. has very long edges. She doesn't chop her way around the ring. A spiral sequence, a serpentine-shaped move across the ice in varying positions of the spiral.
I think she could have better extension on this particular move. It's a beautiful choice of music. Illumination performed by Secret Garden. I do enjoy watching her. She is so beautiful, just floats over the ice.
Had some injury problems earlier, in fact, right before the European Championships with her right leg, but she says she's close to 100% now here at Worlds. Victoria Volchkova.
This triple Lutz, the height is what is to watch for. Look at the extension that she gets there. That's a spring that is God-given. Now, she didn't even do a triple, and she stepped in between, which negated the combination effect of it, but the height was marvelous.
It's her coach, Viktor Kudryavtsev, on the right. He lives in Moscow, so Victoria left her parents in St. Petersburg and lives with her grandparents in Moscow. First set for required elements, 4.6 to 5.2.
Well, she missed her first combination. That requires almost a 0.4 deduction right there.
Now the second set for presentation, 5.1 up to 5.5, so those much higher.
They're higher. Not enough for a woman of this talent.
To be in the running at this point.
That's right.
From the United States, here's Angela Nikodinov, the 19-year-old originally from San Pedro, California, moved over this past season, Rochester Hills, Michigan, to train with Richard Callahan. Fifth in her qualifying group, coming into the short program.
She is a very natural jumper, nice flowing edges on her landings. Opening jump, triple Lutz, double toe. Very solid, strong.
Spin combination, beautiful layback position, good sit spin position. Unusual combination of musical selections. Put work into a triple flip. Watch the toe pick. Good, clean, solid jump.
Now this final jump, a double axel. Very nice. But this is excellent. This is a beautiful position.
This is what she's known for. And would that all of her skating over the past year has been of that level, she would have certainly been here without a doubt. Not waiting to be an alternative.
Angela finished fourth at the U.S. Nationals. Was an alternate for the world team. Sasha Cohen, you may know, who finished second at the Nationals, was not old enough to skate at the World Championships unless she qualified by meddling at the Junior World Championships, and she was not able to do that.
Her spirals don't have the extension like Sarah Hughes and Michelle Kwan's. Very solid number.
I think that's both the good point and the point that has to be approved. A solid performance, a steady performance. Now it needs to have a little more flair and a little more lightness added to it in order to keep the theatrical impact running.
Well, her parents immigrated to the U.S. from Bulgaria. A little European flair for Angela and a lot of fans here from the U.S. French fans on their feet, too.
This is her triple lutz double toe combination right at the beginning of the program. Watch her tap in. Good lift, straight in the air. She looked very comfortable, and the rhythm was right there to go right into the combination of a double toe, and it was a terrific opening for her. This is her classic layback spin. Gorgeous position in the hands, on the upper body, and the leg position. Watch the turnout of the foot. It's absolutely exquisite. The best thing she does.
Now the marks, first set, 5.1 up to 5.7.
That's quite a variation there. I think that the technique was very solid and very good.
Now two of those 5.1s, Netherlands and Romania, and for presentation now, 5.1 again up to 5.6 this time.
And those are somewhat better, and there was a wide variety there. I think if she had a little more energy and spark to it, that it would have gotten still higher, but the technique was first rate.
Up next, Michelle Kwan, once again the U.S. champion, trying to win her third world title here in Nice. She skates next. Titles in 96 and 98, and looking for another world championship in the year 2000. Here is Michelle Kwan, second in her qualifying group. It was the short program that did her in last season in Helsinki when she lost to Maria Butyrskaya.
And because of the technical pressure from so many skaters, Michelle and her coach have changed her solo jump from a triple toe to a triple flip, and she hasn't had this in her program in 2 years. Nice opening double axel.
There's a calmness about her skating, a security, a casualness about it that is very appealing. And she needs this triple lutz, double toe combination. Long back outside edge. Very clean, quality jumping. Layback, the leg is in a better position than it was a year ago, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Better arm positions. She's been working on her spins with Evelyn Kramer, as she calls herself the spin doctor.
Now here is her triple flip. She needs this. Notice the footwork leading into it. Now the turn, the toe pick. Ooh. Oh,
she sure did.
Saved it, but she needed that landing arm to be held back to check the rotation. Here's a magnificent spiral combination. Good sit position, very good sit position. Well, that was, you know, just fine. She saved that one jump. It was completed. There'll be a very, very, very minor deduction for that. Everything was complete. It looked controlled and confident. It was kind of nice to see her back with a smile on her face.
That's a big hurdle out of the way, the short program here at Worlds for Michelle Kwan.
Now, this triple Lutz was really superior. Very easy, very beautifully tight turn, steady edge in between that and the double toe, and it was just fine. It could always be higher, but it was awfully good as it was. Now, look here at the toe pick right there. Now, watch the landing and watch the right shoulder. The right shoulder goes around, swings around. She doesn't check it back until later. And by that time, the control is sort of gone.
UCLA freshman who won her fourth national championship in Cleveland. Different situation for her here at Worlds than she's used to. Slutskaya may be the favorite. Most people talking about her required element marks now, 5.4 to 5.7.
Well, and they're very interesting marks. Note that judge number four has her at the lowest of these marks. And in the presentation marks, I think he also keeps her down. The end result being is that she's in third place by one judge and in first place by all the rest. So those are very, very, very fine marks.
And as she says hello, the main thing is right now she's in first place here in the short. We're coming back with Yulia Sebastian of Hungary, the 18-year-old from Budapest, who finished sixth at the Europeans this season. She's on the move. With Michelle Kwan leading here in the short program, and another American, Angela Nikodinov, in second right now. Here is Yulia Sebastian from Hungary, 18 years of age, from Budapest.
Her opening move is a double axel. Hear this forward edge takeoff.
Nice step up into that. Did you notice how the free leg just stepped up into the air? She's a tall girl, 5'5". Good height again on that first triple Lutz.
Solo jump, a triple flip.
Double.
College student in Hungary, made an amazing jump last year at the World Championships from 19th the year before to 6th.
Looks like she's a wonderful jumper. She has good spring to her jumps and very neat in the air. Where she could improve is expressing this music and holding moves out a little longer, standing up a little straighter when she's stroking around the ice.
Positions are not the best.
Finishing with a Bielman spin. Well, she skated very well.
She's kind of ambivalent about that.
It's funny to watch their expression when they get done, more so with the short program than even the free skate, the sigh, the relief.
If the judge didn't know what to think, the skater will telegraph that from their
exactly.
Face. So all they have to do is watch the end position.
Gonna be a good actor.
This was a wonderful combination she did. She had wonderful spring to this triple Lutz, very straight in the air, and look how high she got on this jump. It was a very natural rhythm, very solid opening.
Currently a college student in Hungary, she finished sixth at this year's European Championships. First set for acquired elements.
And those marks are really not very good. Too many fours in there. That will keep her from having any hope of making a dent in this final group.
And the presentation marks 5.0 from the Italian judge, but up to a 5.5 from the Ukrainian judge. And she's able to jump up in the second over Angela Nikodinov. So she is right behind Michelle Kwan right now. Up next, Irina Slutskaya of Russia, the current European champion. Many consider her the one to beat here in Nice.
Welcome back to the 2000 World Figure Skating Championships here in Nice, France. Our coverage continues now with the ladies' short program.
And taking the ice right now, Irina Slutskaya, the 21-year-old, won a couple of European championships and then fell on hard times, came back this year from the brink, almost gave the sport up. She won another European title, and here she is. Many consider her the favorite to win the gold.
Well, she finally got her head together. She changed her costuming. She changed her choreography. She brought a whole new dimension to it, and that resulted in the success that she's had.
She also got married, and I think she's in the best shape of her life.
Extraordinarily accomplished athlete. Her athleticism is first rate. Look at this triple Lutz jump. Triple Lutz double toe. Almost came to a standstill at the end of it.
Solo jump that Michelle put in her short program. Very nice, good, strong landing.
Very much of a controlled jump.
This is where the huge improvement has been in Irina's skating, is this flow over the ice and her feeling, her music, so much more.
Combination spin, first a camel, sit spin, lay back, catch foot. And a change foot. One of the more successful spin combinations that we've seen.
Well, seeing that Bielman done on the right foot as well as the left foot. Very stretched out.
Final move, a layback. Adequate position, the leg position really not good.
Very well done.
She's happy that one's over.
Well, in the qualifying earlier, both Irina and Michelle were solid and clean, and the judges went with Irina Slutskaya. Michelle was in second in that qualifying group. Her work is done, so is Irina Slutskaya, is now in the short program, and we sit and we wait for the judges.
And this is her triple Lutz double toe combination from the beginning. She had good lift in this triple Lutz, nice straight in the air, but she kind of lost her speed, almost came to a stop in between the combination into the double toe. This was her triple flip that she did later on in the program, the same one that Michelle Kwan put in hers. Hers had good lift, but a much more controlled landing.
And Michelle's not going anywhere for the moment. She wants to sit and wait and watch with the rest of us, find out who will be in first and who will be in second, at least for the moment.
Five.
Last year, Arina Slutskaya could not get through a practice, she said, without being in tears. Now the first set.
The marks are very good, and you know they're strong. She did all the jumps the same as Michelle Kwan did. Michelle Kwan had that little extra sort of delay on that one jump which hurt her. But certainly presentation-wise, I don't think that you can compare Arina Slutskaya with Michelle Kwan.
All but three of the judges put Arina Slutskaya in first place right now. Well, the free skate is going to be something. The young American, 14-year-old Sarah Hugh, the bronze medalist from the national championships in Cleveland, but her second trip to the World Championship. The first one was memorable, a seventh-place finish last season in Helsinki, third in a qualifying group here.
She may look a little different than you saw her at the national championship. This is the new Sarah, with a new haircut and a new costume, and this program suits her so well. Beautiful flowing double axel.
Steady position. Look at how it switches to a forward inside edge. Makes a nice change in that turn.
Remember, the world champion, Maria Butyrskaya, still to skate in the short program and then the free skates a little bit later.
And this is the triple lutz that she has had so much difficulty with the free leg raising high and then slamming into the ice. But this was much gentler, much straighter, and much easier. Good jump combination.
Now her triple flip for her solo jump, the same one that Arina Slutskaya and Michelle did.
Certainly took no chances on that.
There's a real natural elegance to her skating.
Beautiful position. Excellent extension.
Final move, this layback spin.
Good straight standing leg, nice position.
That's a freshman in high school, huh?
We have to pinch ourselves as she's wow. 14. Wow.
It almost looks like the Dorothy Hamill haircut.
Right.
Do you think she's on the way to repeat that Olympic win? Now, in the triple lutz, double toe combination, watch right here the leg, how high it goes. That's been the problem that she's had all along, but it did not affect this jump. Very clean, very easy, very confident. In the triple flip, she has the same problem, but much better jump, much more height to it, and again, very neat, clean, controlled, and just fine. And in the combination spin, look at the positions that she gains here. This sit spin, good position, layback, just fine. Step to the back, now watch her catch this in a back Denise Bielman kind of spin. Wonderful, wonderful position, and here a catch foot.
You know, Rudy Galindo, eat your heart out.
Already among the top contenders at Worlds on their second trip. First set now.
Well, I've got to tell you, those are pretty solid marks. It was a very solid performance. So there's no reason that she should not have been, graced with those marks. They're nice.
Two 5.0s.
Well, that's all right. The bulk of them are 5.4s, and steadily so. 5.5. And the presentation mark, look at the height. Look at those marks. They're really first rate.
Sarah and her coach, Robin Wagner. So that puts Sarah Hughes into third place, right behind Arina Slutskaya and Michelle Kwan right now. 5.3, 5.4. We're coming back with the defending world champion, 27-year-old Maria Butyrskaya from Russia. Don't count her out. Ladies, short program, Arina Slutskaya, Michelle Kwan, and Sarah Hughes, your top three, a Russian skater and two Americans, as the reigning world champion, now takes the ice. Maria Butyrskaya, who won her qualifying group, she was in the other qualifying group from Kwan and Slutskaya, has been written off so many times. It's a great win last year in Helsinki when she upset Michelle.
I really like the fact that when her own federation refused even to acknowledge her, and she just kept right on fighting.
Well, she's had great practices all week. She had a strong qualifying performance, landing 6 out of her 7 triples. She's opening with the triple lutz double toe combination.
You really like to see somebody that fights like that do well. I mean, she's put her heart and soul into this, and that's very encouraging when she finally pulls it off again.
Now her solo jump is a triple loop. Very smooth, nice flowing landing, good speed.
Combination spin. So forward edge. How many times have we seen her just not skate like this, and then to see this kind of a performance come out of it is really very refreshing.
Well, she comes in a very beautiful package. Nice choice of music, good choreography, and a beautiful costume that really relates to this music.
Now this spiral, not as good as either Sarah Hughes or Michelle Kwan. Neither is that layback.
Could be a little faster and
much more extension.
But very solid number. She's got to feel real good about herself. Good for her.
This season, too, kind of a microcosm of her career with all her adversity and the 3 losses to Arina Slutskaya, and people again saying, well, she's over the hill. She doesn't have it anymore. And here she is back believing in herself.
Nice to see. Here's the triple lutz double toe combination at the beginning. Just excellent. It was so solid and secure. Very nice opening for her. Right before she skated out to do this short program, she's wiping her blades off, getting the snow off, and that's where she cut her finger. I've done that many, many times.
Oh, look at these.
Now the marks. Along with her coach, Yelena Chekhovskaya, required elements 5 points, all the way up to a 5.9, three of them.
Yeah, right up there, right up there. They were very, very pleased with that performance.
Wow. For presentation now, and look at those, the 5.8s and 5.9s. All but two of the judges put Maria in the first place.
I think that she was a very complete program and skated with a great deal of stop. Also, she had the benefit of being in last place to skate. And remember, there is no U.S. judge on this panel either. But the consistency of the marks across the line tell the story.
So here's the way they stand after the short program. Butyrskaya over Slutskaya, the Americans, with three skaters in the top seven. Kwan and Hughes in third and fourth, and then Angela Nikodinov in seventh. And the way the scoring breaks down, Michelle Kwan now needs someone else to beat Maria Butyrskaya. She needs some help if she is to win the gold medal. Right now, let's check in with Leslie Visser.
Terry, she is the two-time world champion and looking for a third. How did you feel you did?
Well, I felt really loose out there. I felt that I went for it. I switched since nationals, the triple tone to a triple flip, and I went into it with guts and came out with a little glory, a little bubble there. But in general, I think I skated well.
Do you think the competition is getting tougher and tougher as the years go on?
Competition's always been tough, and I don't think it's getting tougher and tougher. It's just that you have to keep up with it. And right now I feel 100%, and I just want to skate like I have been in practice.
I remember you saying that it was like being at an auction, that somebody bids and you have to bid higher. What do you have to do in the long program?
Well, I have to bid what I'm planning to do out there. I've been skating really well in practices, and I just have to do it just like that.
Well, we'll see if you can close the deal. Thanks, Michelle. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, thanks. She needs some help, but she's within striking distance of the current leader, Maria Butyrskaya. Had a great evening of figure skating here in Nice with the men, the ice dancers, and the ladies. And don't forget, our coverage continues Saturday night in prime time at 9 o'clock Eastern over on ABC Sports. The ladies skate for the title, and Sunday afternoon, the men go for the gold medal at 1 o'clock Eastern on ABC. Up next, the 2000 National High School Cheerleading Championships. Dick Button, Peggy Fleming, Susie Wynn, and Leslie Visser. I'm Terry Gannon. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, a part of Go Network. Go.com. Good night.